They say age is just a number, and for Sheelagh Good, it really is. At 102 years of age, Sheelagh is living life to the fullest, and she is an inspiration to all of us. Last year, Sheelagh suffered a fractured hip, but with the help of Concord Hospital's Transition Care Program in Sydney, she was able to recover and achieve her goal of doing Zumba dance. And we are absolutely thrilled that Sheelagh is joining us this morning with Dr. Janney. Good morning to you. Thank you so much for joining us. Sheelagh, you are an inspiration to all of us. Did you always want to dance the Zumba, or what was your inspiration?
Oh, yes. Oh, I used to love it. In my day, it was a ballroom dancing.
Yeah.
Oh, it was wonderful. And then in the war years, there weren't many men to dance with, so I thought, well, I'm not going to be a wallflower. So I took the male part for my younger dance with my younger sister.
You're good on it.
So you've always loved your dancing.
Oh, yes. Oh, there's nothing like it.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing like it.
So you were fit before you did your hip, and you've been dancing all the way through.
I still dance.
Yes, I know you do.
In the kitchen.
Amazing.
Can I ask you a really personal question?
Oh, it depends how personal it is.
Do you drink?
No, we had a wine bar at Newtown.
Did you?
Which one?
Did. Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
And when the traveller would come round from either McWilliams or Lando, whatever, he would shout for the bar and he'd say, one for you. So I would just pour a little cola.
A pretend drink.
Yes. $1.
Yes. And put the dollar went in your tip jar.
Yes.
Oh, I'd say, cheers. Well, he was none the wiser.
No. I love it. I used to do that when I worked in a pub.
That was cheating.
Doctor, it took only 12 weeks for Sheelagh to achieve her goal. And how did Concord Hospital help with that?
Yeah, look, I think Sheelagh's amazing resilience is a large part of how we got here today. But, I mean, her story is about the sort of whole coordinated system of care that we provide by aged care at Concord Hospital. So it starts as soon as someone like Sheelagh comes to hospital, so the aged care team actually sees her and works with the surgeons to get the surgery done successfully. And then Sheelagh goes to our rehabilitation ward where we have a team of therapists and we look at how we can reduce fractures and falls in the future. And then Sheelagh actually got to do her rehabilitation at home through the transition care program. So having therapists come to Sheelagh in her own home.
I think that's so important.
Absolutely. And that was really important to Sheelagh as well.
Yeah, just to have that care at home is so... I've had it. It's brilliant.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
Makes a big difference, doesn't it?
We call it HIF. You've got to be very careful saying that word.
Doctor, hip fractures are such a huge issue for many elderly Australians and it can lead to long-term problems. Yeah. How important is it to get the right rehabilitation for people that suffer fractures? And also, secondly, how does dance help in the whole holistic approach of recovering?
Yeah, so hip fractures are actually one of the more serious fractures, or one of the most serious fractures from falling. And, I mean, So in terms of Sheelagh and what she experienced, so we get people mobilising straight after surgery, so from day one, early therapy, and then going quickly to that rehabilitation ward and working with them with their goals of care. And, I mean, her dancing meant that you were sort of even fit to begin with. I mean, Sheelagh's just a remarkable ambassador of healthy aging. But no, it's really important. So we've actually got a fracture prevention service at Concord Hospital. So we do look at how we can reduce risk of falls in future and reduce risk of fractures. Our therapists go to the home, make sure there are no falls hazards around.
Yeah.
Doctors look at things like medications, stop those that can make people a bit unsteady on their feet.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes, all
now,
the
Now, Sheelagh,
things.
why Zumba? Or why not?
Exactly. I mean, it's very good for the legs because I have sciatica and osteoarthritis. So,
you got a few things there. But listen,
would you
be able to give us a couple of dance moves, the Zumba dance moves here?
Here,
would you, yeah. If
the trouble is, look.
How are you? You're only a tiny little thing, aren't you?
Yes. There was never very much. Well, you're not that big yourself.
And And Sheelagh, while you're doing...
You're wearing a very full...
Oh, I know.
Sheelagh, what's your secret to living a long life to before you show us the...
I drink lots of cups of tea.
Do you?
And biscuits, yes.
Tea and biscuits. I love it.
Like my hot cuppa.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And can you show us...
I didn't know we had the wine bars to say I didn't drink.
Oh, OK.
Uh-huh.
Can you show us a couple of moves?
Zumba.
Have we got any music?
Zumba. Yeah.
Have we got a little bit of music?
Can we have a bit of music?
I like to...
We're ready.
Yeah, we're sort of, you know, sort of we do shake it, baby. Yeah.
Good on you.
Oh, good.
Shake it, baby, shake.
Fabulous.
Shake it, baby,
fabulous.
Sheelagh, you've got some moves.
She has.
At 102, you are fabulous. Yeah. Big round of applause for fantastic Sheelagh again. Yeah.
Wonderful.
And age is no barrier, and you have the most beautiful sparkle in your eyes. So thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Yeah, well,
exactly.
I like people.
Aww.
Yeah, that helps.
Indeed.
Yes, I do like people, everybody.
Yeah.
Good on you. Thank you for joining us. And Sheelagh, you're such an inspiration. Age is no barrier. And thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Exactly. I mean, you know, as I say, some days I feel only 200 when my hips sore. But other days, you know, I feel 60.
Yeah. Bless you.